I mean, Stanley's absolutely lethal.
It's lovely to talk to you both about Wild Mountain Thyme. Your characters have obviously known each other for years and they've both got their quirks. So I was wondering, what's the weirdest thing that you learned about each other whilst filming that you otherwise wouldn't have known?
Oh my goodness. Jamie, what did I learn about you that's weird? Everything. Just in general, sort of air of weirdness about Jamie. I remember my first day working with Jamie, we were doing this like slight argument outside of the car. And I can't even physically show what you did because you won't be able to see it on the camera. But he literally, before the take, as the camera was rolling, he did the strangest thing where he just leant over and started to dig the dirt in front of him. It was like some strange physical tick to try and get rid of the nerves. It was all stuff like that that I discover, that Jamie has strange tendencies. I think we all do. That's kind of the beauty of getting to play really strange people, is that I think we all recognize that we're all a bit weird and strange, you know? So I think when you get to play people like that, then all of those nuances can come out, and that was fun.
Very early on, the night before we started shooting, I realized I wasn't feeling that well, and Emily gave me this stuff called thieve oil, which very nearly killed me. And,
but it cured you. You felt so much better the next day. Do you remember?
In all fairness, I did. It is the most rancid, you know, unpalatable substance I've ever put near my mouth. But I have to admit, it did clear up my cold. Emily survived.
There you go. You're welcome.
Yeah! Besotted with love.
There's these green fields, and there's us. Whatever that is, it holds me here.
Oh, what is this, those things?
It's not normal.
I don't care.
It's such a lovely film for people to watch over Christmas. Do you guys have any, like, Christmas traditions that you do every year without fail?
I don't know if there's anything specific that not everyone does. I mean, I feel like everyone probably does what what I was going to say. The thing that I notice now living in America is that in England, I remember growing up that when we were growing up, my dad would leave out mince pies and brandy for Father Christmas. And in America, they leave out milk and cookies. And so I remember, and my dad's whole thing was like, surely Father Christmas needs a drink. Because he's like going around the world delivering gifts. And I think I agree with the British way. So I think maybe this year I'm going to say no to the milk and we should just leave out the brandy or the whiskey and we can have a good time.
He's had a tough year, Father Christmas.
Had a tough year.
Similar, like, you know, we've got young kids who very much in the throes of Santa belief, and it's great. So we do this whole thing every year where my wife and I put out mince pies and whiskey, actually. And I mean, imagine how hammered Santa would be if he actually took on all this booze that's presented for him.
That's why his cheeks are so rosy. He's quite ruddy from all the alcohol.
That's probably. But then obviously the kids, we do that, and then the kids go to bed.
Anthony, time is running out.
What is love? Is it a quest? What are you doing? A madness.
How many days do we have while the sun shines?
It's not shining.
Along with like Tiger King and John's Good News shows, I feel like Stanley Tucci's cocktail classes have really been making people very excited during lockdown. Emily, please tell me you've tried one of his cocktails.
Oh, every time I go over to his house, I have a new cocktail. I mean, Stanley's absolutely lethal because you go over and the cocktails are so good, they kind of go down like water. So I've had all and actually there is another cocktail video coming up that we just all worked on, so get ready.
He should just like leave out an array for Santa.
I think he does do that.
Well, thank you both so much for talking to me. I've got to say, I did feel really, really sorry for you both just getting drenched.
It was fine.
So, I had like Lady Gaga and Ariana Grande rain on me playing in my head. I feel bad, getting soaked.
That would be actually amazing if that had been the soundtrack, Jamie, for our film. That would have been so funny.
Yeah. You and Carl and Ari could collab.
Collab.
Thank you so much, guys, and huge congrats.
Thanks, Olivia. Thank you.
Thank you.